By the end of this video, you should feel comfortable and confident in giving a relaxation massage to anyone. Hello guys, my name is Ashta. Welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be reviewing Swedish massage techniques. So without further ado, let's get into the video. The first technique that we're gonna go over today is rocking, and don't underestimate this beautiful technique because it is a powerful sedative technique which is extremely useful for reducing stress-related autonomic dysfunction. To perform this technique, place the palms of your hands on the client and apply gentle lateral forces so that the body is oscillating with its own natural rhythm. Rocking pairs great with compressions, which is what I'm demoing here. To use this technique, use the palmar surface of your hand and apply downward, light to heavy pressure into your body's tissue. Compressions can be utilized to increase lymphatic return of a body, increase venous return to the body, and if your pressure is hard enough, it can actually have a mechanical effect too, which is great for reducing tonicity and tightness. Here I'm using more of a light to medium pressure, again just further introducing my touch to the body, further sedating him, and I'm also assessing his body, assessing the tightness and toneness of the muscles in his back, side of his glutes, and through his legs as well. Okay, now the fun part. We're gonna get into our oil-based techniques now. So you're gonna need some oil, and it doesn't need to be fancy. Many of the therapists at my clinic simply use coconut oil. Warm it up onto your hands before you get started and distribute the oil with this technique here called effleurage. To perform effleurage, you're going to use the palmar surface of your hand and apply light to medium pressure downwards and then light pressure on the way back up. The key concept to this technique is you want to keep complete palmar contact onto the body's skin during the upstroke and back on the downstroke. Effleurage is mainly used to distribute oil to the area you are working on. It is used to introduce your touch, but it's also a way to close your touch. So when you're done with the massage, 1 to 3 effleurages is perfect. This next technique is called stroking, and it can look very similar to effleurage, but there are many different variations. To perform stroking, you'll use your palms, knuckles, or even your forearms to apply light to medium pressure over a body region or a muscle. Stack your palms over top of one another for a reinforced palmar stroke that's going to help you achieve a greater depth of pressure without hurting your own body. You can also do knuckle stroking and forearm stroking. Just be careful when you're using your forearm stroking to go around the shoulder blade and avoid contact with the spine. Stroking is a very relaxing technique, so again, it will help reduce stress-related autonomic dysfunction, but especially when we're working on the limbs, the feet, the arms, we're pushing stagnant lymph, stagnant blood back to the heart, increasing circulation. And as we get deeper, we're affecting the muscles. So increasing extensibility, the length of the muscle, and decreasing tonicity, the tightness of a muscle. It is very important when working on the legs or the arms that all your strokes should always push blood towards the heart. Never do stroking in the opposite direction. This next technique is called petrissage, and there are 5 main types: muscle squeezing, muscle stripping, wringing, picking up, skin rolling, kneading. I know it's a lot, let's break it down. To perform kneading, you can use your palms, thumbs, fingertips, or knuckles and apply rhythmical circular motions with alternating pressure and release. A fun variation of kneading are called open C's. You make 2 C's with your finger and your thumb and keep full palmar contact with the skin and imagine making tiny little figure eights. They feel pretty good. To perform muscle stripping, you'll use your thumb, forearm, knuckles, fingertips, and just strip along the muscle fiber. So this muscle runs from the wrist to the elbow, so I'm just stripping along that muscle with my thumb. Here I'm using my knuckles to strip along that giant trapezius muscle. and the forearms are great for stripping along the erectors. These two compressive techniques, muscle stripping and muscle kneading, are perfect for decreasing muscular restrictions and decreasing tonicity of hypertoned muscles. Next, we have wringing, and wringing feels so good. To perform this technique, place your hands on opposite sides of the body, allowing your fingers and your palms to just melt into the contour of the body, and then bring your hands together, creating a lift, a sheer, a torque of everything underneath the skin, the fascia, the muscle. Lift and release, lift and release, lift and release. This feels amazing. Here we have picking up. It's another variation of lifting. So using both sides of your hands, just lifting that tissue up into the air, releasing it back down, lifting it up again, back down, and lifting up back again. Muscle squeezing is very similar, but I would say it's less dynamic, more about just getting a hold of that muscle, in this case lats, and just squeezing the muscle together between your thumb and your finger or both palms. Muscle squeezing, muscle picking up, and wringing have a lot of similar components involving a lot of lifting and squeezing, which makes these techniques great for loosening adhesive muscle tissue, increasing circulation, and really stretching underlying muscle fibers. Some love it, some hate it. This technique is called skin rolling. I personally love this technique. It feels so good, but people who have really thick skin sometimes find this to be a little bit too intense, too burny. To perform skin rolling, the skin is lifted between the thumb and the fingers and gently rolled over the area being treated. This will help for loosening any adhered cutaneous and fascial layers. And that covers petrissage. Moving on to frictions. Frictions is a very deep and specific technique. If you have any specific adhesions or dysfunctionality, scar tissue that causes point-specific pain, this is the technique for you. Here I am doing frictions along the upper traps. The upper traps run along the shoulders and insert into the back of the head. To locate the muscle, first I'll get the body to fire off the upper traps by doing a simple shoulder shrug. That way I know I'm on the right muscle. And then use reinforced fingertips to apply transverse or circular movements to the underlying tissue. Afterwards, I like to flush out the area by doing some nice knuckle stroking, and then I'll go ahead and fire off that muscle again just to realign those muscle tissues. We broke them all apart and now we just want to align them again with muscle activation. Again, frictions are great for treating tissue adhesions, scar tissue, but also tendonitis, ligament sprains, and joint restrictions. This next technique is called shaking. It is a relaxing technique and it can reflexively relax hypertoned muscles. I saved the best for last, and that is tapotement. This variation is called pincement. It is quick, light pinching movements using the thumbs and fingertips. Point percussion, percussive movements performed with the fingertips, one hand alternating after the other. Clapping, performed with the palmar surface and the fingers striking flat against the surface of the body. And here we have cupping, percussive movements performed with the hand in a cupped position. This is called loose digital ulnar border percussion, and just imagine doing a karate chop except your hand is slightly limp, creating a more softer effect. Now straighten the hands and harden that karate chop, and this is called a hard digital ulnar border percussion. It's a little bit more intense, a little deeper. And this last one is called drumming. You can perform it again similarly with the loose fist or harden your fist together for a more intense impact. Tapotement's really cool because it can be stimulating or relaxing. If you have a body that needs to get back to work right away, I recommend doing tapotement over their back for 30 seconds. That should wake them up. But anything longer than that, it can become increasingly relaxing. Also, if you know anyone with bronchitis or congested lungs, if you do tapotement on their back for 30 seconds, that's going to help them greatly dislodge some of that built-up mucus that's kind of stuck in their lungs. There's another variation of tapomin that's very gentle, and that is fingertip tapping, using just the fingertips to do percussive movements. I generally like to do this one on the forehead. It can be very relieving, soothing, and distracting if people are suffering from headaches. Swedish massage is not complicated or hard. Follow these techniques and you can massage any part of the body and guarantee to relax your client and decrease some hypertoned muscles in the process. If you like this video, please give this a huge thumbs up. Your support means the absolute world to me. You can follow me on Instagram at ashtuffmassage, and please subscribe if you're interested in seeing more massage videos. I like to do stretching exercises and of course lots and lots of massage. I'll see you at the next video. Thanks for watching. Mwah.